The United States and the Arab League have long agreed that with respect to Syria, which we did discuss today, the end of this civil war is going to require a political solution. We have repeated, and I repeat every time I stand up and talk about it, there is no military solution. And what the United States is seeking together with others, not alone, but with others, an increasing number, what we are seeking is to enforce the standard with respect to the use of chemical weapons. We are not seeking to become engaged in or party to or take over Syria's civil war. But as we discussed today, all of us agreed, not one dissenter, that Assad's deplorable use of chemical weapons, which we know killed hundreds of innocent people, including at least 426 children on this occasion, this one occasion, this crosses an international, global red line. And we agree that the regime's blatant disregard for the institutional norms that the global community has abided by for nearly a century, it is critical that those be upheld. So today we discuss the possible and necessary measures that the international community can take to deter Assad from ever crossing that line again. And a number of countries immediately signed on to the G20 agreement that was reached by now 12 countries on the side of the G20 meeting, and they will make their own announcements in the next 24 hours about that.